Hey guys, welcome to another episode in the deep playthrough of Gran Turismo 4. We are slowly but surely making our way towards 100%, still under 25%, but we are going through the special condition events, normal difficulty level. We are doing the Capri Rally. And what I noticed with these normal events, that the competitor cars can be quite quick, so it's pretty tricky to find a suitable car that is not overpowered but also not way too slow. So I am using this whole special condition events also to buy new cars, just to grow the garage and get cool new cars. But I also don't want to, I still have 700,000. I don't want to buy new cars for each and every normal risk one or normal difficulty one, because I probably need some money for the hard ones. That's where I really need some good cars. So for now, let's continue in the car that we were driving. Let's see how it goes. We are currently on the Subaru Impreza 22B with medium racing tires. For the rest, it's stock. Yeah, we are driving against a newer Impreza, which is actually quicker. Gets away slowly but surely. Hopefully that the racing tires do their job. Holy shit. I do think they are doing their job. We seem to be more grippy in the corners. And I think it will be 3 laps. It's actually quite fun. It's not too difficult, this one. But we are somewhat somewhat of a balanced race as regards to speeds between the two cars. Way too much braking here. I'm an idiot. Much braking again, but this seems to be quite an easy one, quite an easy race. Nice, just what I needed after a day of annoying work. Just a relaxing race. Oh, wrong gear. Again, braking way too early over there. You do need to brake there, otherwise you get airborne and you just smash into the wall. Alright, this first right-hander, I can brake a little bit. Oh shit! That was a close one. Luckily, it didn't bring me to a full stop on that little pole over there. I wanted to say the first right-hander, I can brake less, but still, you have to brake there because I went totally wide. Fuck me, man. Alright, almost lost the race there. Somehow this car has snap oversteer while braking. Fuck me, man. Again, way too much braking. I brake later. But I was thinking I actually did go airborne, but I didn't. So I kept the brake pedal pressed, thinking I was in the air, so I would brake a little bit once I would get back on the ground. But I was actually full time connected to the ground. So keeping the brake pedal pressed resulted in way too much braking. No, no, not again. Oh, oh, oh. Fuck that corner, man. Second time. Good thing I have a little bit of a lead. Alright, remember that corner, it's really tricky. Because you're going downhill, the rear of the car gets light. And then it just overtakes the front. Because you have some steering angle. But yeah, really pretty easy. Let's skip the replay. We already watched quite some Costa di Amalfi replays. By the way, I did get a very cool car at the end of the previous episode. I think it was a Lancia Integrale rally car. We can use that one for the next race. Let's get to the next one. This is just reverse. We are in a faster car, I guess. compared to competition. I'm not really sure of the breaking points. But yeah, we can take it easy. Just more or less a relaxing drive around a beautiful track. And again, so easy to have the rear of this car brake free under braking. Super annoying. Right, this is my favorite piece of track. Downhill, this section. You see the ocean in the distance. It's really a very nice laid out track, I find. Here, just like this part, you see a little bit less of the ocean. But still nice. Again, that's the problem here. Actually, I'm in too fast of a car, of course. Fuck me. Alright, braking distance is much earlier, or the braking point. But yeah, we are actually, it is fun. I'm happy that I'm not like in a nail-biting, frustrating race again. To be able to win it, but because I'm also a little bit tired. But conceptually, it's not really okay, of course, that we're, yeah, you just have to find your own car, but either good chance that your car is way too slow, or it is way too quick, like mine is now. Although the first race was a little bit more closer, but it's probably because I was way quicker, probably because of the racing tires. I had to put them on this car because of an earlier race on Costa di Amalfi, where we had to drive against a 1984 Mitsubishi Sterion rally car, which really was much quicker than my car, than this Subaru Impreza 22B. And the thing is, I also couldn't really see what kind of tires that rally car was on. I only knew it was much quicker. So I was like, maybe it's also on racing tires, so that's why. I put racing tires on this car, but yeah, against other opponents makes it a little bit too easy. totally forgot to brake over there. Man, this track has such a nice color tone. By the way, I'm like, what the hell? It's like a little open garden there. All right, let's check that out, that little open garden. Just curious. Maybe there's a little Easter egg in there. Where the hell is my fucking... I have no idea. Ah, this is the handbrake. Anyways, let's quickly check out that little garden over there. There really is nothing there, right? But still pretty nice. That it's like an open fence. If I were the developers, I would have maybe put... It's so annoying if you're playing on a wheel and your reverse button is just one of 20 buttons on the wheel, and then you steer your wheel and then you have no clue where the reverse button is anymore, because your wheel is 180 degree or 720 degree or whatever. Nope, nothing there. It's also pretty cool. I'm not sure whether you hear it in the video, but you do hear the, it's of course not that big of a track. It's mostly also verticality, etc. So the opponent car in like a straight line is probably not that far away, and I do hear him in the distance racing through the mountains. How he's getting closer. Let's wait for him. There he goes. Anyways, this was Costa di Amalfi. Sorry for that weird sidestep at the end, checking out a random garden for potential Easter eggs. Alright, please let it be a cool car. Rally car prototype 1. This one is pretty usable, I guess, for the difficult events. Although I really don't like the bug eye, give me the blob eye, preferably. But for now, let's go to Grand Canyon and let's use that Lancia Delta HF Integral. Pretty epic car, I would say. We do need some dirt tires. Which are actually quite expensive. wonder, what are the classics of Lancia? Stratos, Integral, Stratos Rally Car, Integral Rally Car. Can you buy this one? No, you can only win it, there's no price. And Delta S4, man, that are pretty cool Group B rally cars. We have the Peugeot 205, I think, T16. We have the Delta S4, we have the Stratos. I also saw the Audi Quattro, I think. Pretty damn cool. Anyways, here we go. Right, yeah, again, against a much older car, but I think it is, by the way, another Group B rally car, pretty cool, and I'm pretty sure it will be, we also have a rally car, so we don't have like a regular HF Integral with dirt tires. No, we really have a dedicated rally car, so hopefully we will be competitive. Normally you would think we would be much quicker in a much newer car, a younger car. But I learned from that Mitsubishi Starion in the previous episodes that production year really does not necessarily mean newer is quicker. Because that 1984, that's the same year as his RS200 rally car, that Mitsubishi Starion, was much quicker than like a 1998 Mitsubishi Impreza. Anyways, let's... I wonder, Group B cancelled. When did Group B got cancelled? I think that must have been also around 1984, because I read that that Mitsubishi Starion was built for Group B, but actually was ready too late to actually participate before the whole class got cancelled because of too many deaths and too risky. Alright, within hours of the accident, the FISA banned Group B cars from competing in the 1987 season. Alright, so... Group B was to be terminated at the end of the 1986 season. For the rest of the season, a new set of rules were drawn up. This included... Wait, on the 5th March 1986, Group B was coming to an end. Santos was seated... but still were... Santos was seated 12th and the lead drivers were already through the stage and the road was less busy with spectators, but still there were occasional spectators standing in the middle of the road to cheer on the local drivers. Coming from a fast right-hand corner and into a tighter right-hander, over a small crest on a downhill section, Santos lost control of the car after a spectator stepped into the road, causing him to swerve and spun right into the crowd. Two children and a woman were killed on the spot and 30 injured, with one of the injured children later dying in the hospital. This saw the start of the end. I think that was in an RS200. The organizers didn't stop the stage until about 10 more cars had started. The stage was 5 kilometers long and the accident happened around 4 kilometers from the start, meaning that delay in stopping was unacceptably long. On top of that, top drivers were informed of the incident only after they had covered two more stages and arrived to rest holds, ready to tackle those three stages again. Ford then decided to pull their remaining cars out of the rally. After Portugal, FISA started to plan the new rules for 1987. This would eventually be Group A. He was the only driver that could really control, maximize the power of the S4. Henry. On stage 18, Henry Tovenen and Serge Questra were tragically killed when their Lancia Delta S4 left the road on the left-hand corner, roughly 7 kilometers away from court. Within hours of the accident, the FISA banned Group B cars from competing in the 1987 season. Alright, so... Alright, this is about when they went from Group B to Group A cars. Then they gave me what was going to be our new car to test at Ivalo in Finland. I was really shocked. Compared to the S4, the Group A Delta felt like a road car. Our S4 was developing 700 horsepower by the end. The Group A Delta had around 230. It just felt like driving a road car and I was so frustrated by everything. I really wondered what the point was in continuing. Wow, interesting. But let's, before I continue, that first accident, that is Joaquim Santos. Let's see, because I only see a picture of a wreck. I wonder whether that was also a Ford RS200. Yes, pretty sure that is a Ford RS200. Sorry for that long detour, it was just a learning moment. But what I then don't understand is that what I read about that Mitsubishi Stereo in 1984, that it was ready too late to compete in Group B, while Group B still continued until 1986. But yeah, that I must be overlooking something. Anyways, let's... we are hopefully competitive, because it's only a 7-point race. Shit, this car is quite more twitchy than earlier other cars that I drove here. I'm not sure, either I'm really just driving slow. I'm not really sure why this is only a 20-point race when competitor is so much quicker, and this car really controls quite tricky, I must say. I will continue just as practice run, but man, this car really goes quite wide. Jesus Christ, man, what an annoying car this is. I mean, it looks amazing, and I really am a big fan of the Lancia Integrale. But controlling it in this game, compared to others, I'm not too happy with it. We are at 7 seconds. Let's at least see. If we can reduce the gap. No, not really actually. Lead. If you are immediately in first place, you can maybe keep him behind you, but for the rest, I'm a little bit disappointed by this car, to be honest. I will try a couple more times, but otherwise I will just switch cars. Yeah, it does look like I'm quicker. So annoying. Alright, now we're getting into the frustrating phase of a lot of episodes. This is what I mean. God damn it, that car is much quicker. I also don't want to change car too quickly. Because that also feels a bit cheap. But god damn it, this car slides all over the place. Cool that the AI also makes mistakes. I really like that. I really was not expecting still to have a chance here. Man, don't screw it up. I'm really screwing it up. In this corner, he is just so much quicker. Right, hopefully he will make the same mistake again. Like last time. Fuck me, man. I'm literally standing still here. And that's all my own doing, and now I'm actually making the same mistake he did over there. going wider. Alright, it looks like he made a similar mistake because he did get a little gap. Right, I'm really not driving that well, but my only savior is the fact that these roads are very narrow, so it's hard for him to pass me. But now we again come to the area where he is so much quicker, in these wide flowing corners. Again, I'm braking too much here. I hear him. Ah, fuck me, man. Right, I do have to say, it's quite epic. Right, please go wide. Holy shit, he went wide again. I was afraid of getting a penalty while passing him and touching him. Luckily that didn't happen. Way too much braking on my side again. Fuck me, man. I really have to be careful because he has no problems. Getting past me on the outside. No, 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 ah, fuck me, big time, fuck me, big time, I have to do it again. Alright, I do have to say it was quite an exhilarating race, but at the same time, I'm pretty bummed out that I lost it at the end, fuck me, man. Fuck me. Because we also have to do it in reverse still, so it's quite a long event. Again, I'm just screwing it up myself, seriously. Bumping barriers left and right. Fuck me, man. Need to get that drifting better down. Again, I hear him like breathing in my neck. And again, he's gaining on me here. It's so annoying. Totally lose all momentum through these corners. Super annoying. And again, losing all my momentum for no reason. Overshooting this one. Fucking hell, 3 seconds lead, and I'm never keeping the lead. I always lose it. Here, fucking screwing up that corner, and now he's back. Thank you. Totally screwing it up again. This is where he gains. Way too much braking, no power slides. Lost all momentum. And again, he's gaining, I'm screwing up. He almost really just deserves to win. Way too much braking. Fuck me, man. And again, in the last section, I'm totally screwing it up. Right, finally, goddammit. Phew. Alright, now in reverse. I really, man, I'm sweating. I'm in a country for work where it's so fucking hot. Totally not used to that. And it's not global warming, it's just my more southern country. Oh my god. Why did I move here? Ah, fuck me, man. And now he is bumping and I'm getting a penalty. He bumped into something and then I bumped into him. Yes, ah, fuck this fucking shit, man. Oh, fuck it, fuck it. He has so much better power slides. I'm just all over the place. He's really not making jokes. He really squeezes. His car in between. I just need to do a practice run. I really need to. Yeah, this is what I mean. Fuck that shit, man. Fuck that shit. Anyways, I really need to learn the track as well from this side. And here again, this is what I mean with screwing up my slides. In these sections, he is so much quicker. I'm not enjoying me. It's really a chore, this, to get through. And it's for some part also due to the car. It is not terribly handling, but yeah, I find the Subaru Impreza or something like that much better. Fuck this shit, man. Fuck this shit. He always bumps the tree there, and then I bump into him. So you need to be in front of him. Fuck this fucking game. Why doesn't he get a penalty now? This is just pure frustration. He bumps me like a motherfucker. And if I only graze him... fuck this, fuck this, fuck this, fuck this. If I only graze him, I'm getting a 5-second penalty. Totally fucked up. And it's also because I don't know the track that well from this side, this direction. Fuck me, man. Oh, fuck me, man. Fuck. All right, I need to race this part because I need to get to know the track here. Oh, fuck me. Oh, fuck me. It's so annoying sliding out these corners. Right, I will do one more round as a practice run. And then I just need to keep him behind me. Seconds in the lead. Pretty crazy. Oh man, this going wide in these corners, it's so frustrating. So incredibly frustrating. Oh my gosh, this is not fun at all. Or it would be if it would not be so hot and if I would have more time. Gap. Oh my god, and my time. Oh, wrong button. Oh man, man. So much frustration in this game. So much. I don't have a lot of time tonight, and I do want to fucking win this race. Why this is only a 7-point race? Don't ask me. Seriously. all a matter of keeping him behind you. Especially in these quick flowing corners. No! This was it. So once he gets past, I'm screwed. Oh, fuck this so fucking hard, man. Fuck it so hard. Fuck my life. And again, going wide, it's so annoying. Oh, fuck me. He's just bumping into me, pretty damn sure. fuck me, man. Was not expecting that. Fuck me. All right, that is simply a goner. So I cannot take him anymore. He's just too quick. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Oh, and again, I'm thinking this is the new race. It's only the replay. It's all so fucking frustrating. Seriously. Man, if I just keep my lines here, I can build up some margin for the sections where he's so much quicker. It really is not that hard. If I don't make mistakes like this. I had like a pretty nice lead and I'm just screwing it up. Here, I'm just going through these corners like a snail. And again, going wide there. Come on, man. No! Oh! Oh my god, oh my fucking god, man. It's just a matter of staying, being consistent. I don't even need to be that fast when he's behind me. I just must not be extremely slow and making stupid mistakes. Fuck me. And again, totally screwing up with my momentum. What's wrong with me? Seriously? This is the way how you lose races. Being overly cautious. Way too much braking for no reason. Way too little braking for no reason. No, oh, going wide, and this is where he gets me. In this flowing section, he's so much quicker. Especially this corner here. He really doesn't make take prisoners here. He just goes around the sides. Here, this is what I mean. Totally missed that corner again, me. then totally screwing it up. Why? Oh, why am I going wide there? I had like a little gap. I'm again screwing it up. Finally, fuck me, god damn it. God damn it, that was an annoying race. Alright, at least we made it. Let's quickly, I don't have a lot of time, sorry for that. Let's watch one lap of replay. God damn it. Right, quite some slowdown with the Vulcan renderer compared to DirectX 12. A lot of slowdown. I can tell you, it's pretty annoying if a much faster car is behind you all the time. And it's not so much a faster car, but it's just a better driver, so to say. But all in all, again, I do like the challenge with its frustrations better than having like a super dumbed down game. This does give that sense of accomplishment, like that little endorphin rush at the end once you do get it. And it's actually a pretty cool race to look at as well. Yeah, I do like this rally driving mechanic here, the sliding. It is also because I don't have time, I'm distracted by my work, etc. There are all kinds of excuses why I'm getting moody and frustrated. If I would have all the time in the world, I would love to play these races 24/7. But yeah, so I may sound super negative, but actually I really do like the rally mechanics in this game. I like them much better than I thought I would like them from 19 years ago. Really, the slides, you can control the slides quite well. It's just pretty good physics in this game. And this is really a hard-won battle. Check out how close he is. So amazing, but I unfortunately have to end the episode because real life is calling. Don't ask me why. I really would prefer to just 24/7 game, but even on my old age. But yeah, you know how it goes. Next episode, yeah, I'm afraid that the ice arena is coming up. Also really not looking forward to that one. And Chamonix. Ah, at least we get a bonus car. Tarmac rally car. Alright. Does it look like a concept car? It looks like a genuine rally car. So this one goes into the garage. I don't like all those weird concept cars. I immediately remove them from the garage. Let's see. Yeah, Ice Arena and Chamonix. So next couple of rallies will also be a little bit frustrating, or probably a lot frustrating. Muy frustration. Muy difícil. Right, we're almost at 25%, meaning that we can access the endurance events. The menu at least, it's for now it's still locked. Guys, hope you enjoyed. Hope to see you in the next one. Sorry for all the negative energy from me in this episode, but yeah, sometimes it is what it is. Hope to see you in the next one. For the meantime, don't forget, always do keep on gaming. Later.